Hello everyone, my name is Ishita Mangal. I am a fashion designer and a content creator. Today I'm going to be telling you about what are the things that you need to keep in mind when you're picking a sari for your farewell, and not just for farewell but also for young girls who are just starting to wear a sari. A farewell is such an important time for a girl. It's most likely the first time every girl is wearing a sari. Also, it can be overwhelming because sari is often looked as a garment that is difficult to handle. It's not after a point, but I can imagine how for somebody who is wearing it the first time it can be, and it can be a little overwhelming to style it, to look for it, and you know, to just basically wear it on the day. So I'm going to be giving you some tips and tricks for that. Before we get started with the video, can I please request you to subscribe to my channel? It's really important that you do that, and without further ado, let's just get started with the video. So the first thing that you need to keep in mind is that your farewell sari needs to be lightweight. And it needs to be lightweight for two reasons. One, it will be easy to manage. And two, it will not overwhelm your look. Saris in materials like georgette, chiffon, tissue, organza, cotton are easier to manage and are lightweight. Anything which is heavy and adorned with a lot of embroidery can be a little harder to carry and might be more wedding appropriate than farewell appropriate. With the way you walk, you will trip and fall multiple times. So it's better to make sure that the sari is easy to manage. When you're choosing a blouse, then again, keep it simple. If you're going for an Indian style blouse, then you can go for a scoop neck with or without sleeves, halter neck, or even a deep V-neck. I would personally actually prefer to wear a top as a blouse, like a turtleneck, a crop top, a bralette, a shirt, or even a t-shirt. Not this one. This one is quite problematic. But you know what I mean. Keep the blouse edgy and feel free to mix the Indian sari with a Western style blouse. It will look unique and will also be easier to manage. Another reason why I love tops is that you can wear your bra with it instead of worrying about the fitting of the cups or the stitched blouse. Aise aise karna would be easy, no? Go easy on the jewelry to keep the vibe of the look effortless and fresh. You do not need to look like a Christmas tree. You can definitely wear big statement jewelry, but don't wear everything together. Maybe just a heavy choker or heavy earrings or a head harness or maybe a ear cuff or just maybe light jewelry. This totally depends on your personal style and the look that you're going for. What I mean is that feel free to experiment, but do not get decked up. Always opt for comfortable footwear. Wedges, platform heels, block heels, juttis or sneakers. Wow, sneakers would look amazing. But opt for these comfortable shoes instead of something like pencil heels, because they are going to make you extremely uncomfortable. They would get stuck in the grass or poke your sari. You will be a mess. A hot mess, but still a mess. So be cautious of this and only go for comfortable shoes with your farewell sari. Go for a fuss-free hairstyle. Do not go for those gigantic buns that brides do that honestly doesn't even look good on them. You're going to hate me for this comment, no? But seriously, keep your hair fuss-free. You can keep it open, you can slick it at the back, you can tie a ponytail, you can even go for a bun, but nothing which is too overwhelming or too weddingy. Feel free to use interesting accessories like hair vines or hair clips or fake flowers if your look demands one. Just keep it simple yet stylish. When it comes to makeup, I would say that go all out and feel free to experiment as much as you can. You can do some interesting graphic eyeliner, you can do a colored mascara, you can do great poppy eyeshadow, you can do some bold lips or glittered lips. I mean, the options are like limitless, right? I'm pretty sure all of you would know a lot more about makeup than I do. So go crazy with it and experiment with it, because this is the time to sort of, I think this is the time when everybody sort of starts experimenting with makeup, and feel free to play with your face, but make sure that it's not too cakey or too wedding-y. That is just my opinion, and but let me know what you guys like when it comes to doing makeup. If this is your first time wearing a sari, you need to enjoy wearing one. Have fun with your look, experiment with your style, add a touch of your fun side. If you're desi, a rebel, a goth-inspired girl, or an anime-inspired girl, whatever it is, show us that fun side of you. A sari is one of the most versatile garments because it is essentially just a piece of cloth. There is so much experimentation that is yet to happen with this. For all you know, you could be coming up with a totally different way of styling one. You could be seeing this video for all the tips. You could be seeing other videos or articles, but trust me, you are your best stylist. Go crazy and don't forget to tell me how you plan to style yours. If you're watching this video for someone else or for yourself, and you feel that I might have missed a tip that I have not shared with you, then please feel free to share it in the comments. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. Let me know in the comments if you did. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much again. My name is Ishita Mangal and I will see you next time. Bye!